to PSM, Perfect Solution for Maths. I'm your tutor Sumant PF. Today's topic is Arithmetic Progression, Unit 5 for the NCERT and Unit 1 for the KSEEB. We have already finished how to find the nth term of a given AP. So that we have finished already, that is exercise 5.2 NCERT and 1.2 for the KSEEB also we have finished. We are now the next step, that is the next topic, very important topic, that is sum of the first n terms of an AP. This is the new topic we have, the new concept we have. It is not based on the nth term, it is the sum of the first n terms of an AP. So let us learn one by one how to find the sum of that n terms. So those who have missed my previous videos, that is nth term video, that is 5.2 exercise and all, you can check in the description. There I have given the link, there you can click, and there are 13 parts in the arithmetic progression. One by one you can learn all the problems. Now we can move on to the sum of the first n terms of an AP. To understand what is that sum of the first n terms of an AP, we have to take some examples to explain. So here I am going to take some examples, and which are AP that we have to consider. So I will write down two examples of AP, that is first one I will take a simple one, 1, 4, 7, 10, so on. Okay, this is the first example, and here you can see all are AP or not, all are in a AP or what, we have to check that. So first one, 4 minus 1 is 3 obviously, 7 minus 4 is 3 again, okay, and then 10 minus 7 is 3, so it is in AP. So we have to find sum of it. So it is easier, only 4 terms are there, we have to add and we have to find. So what is the sum? Sum is will be denoted as SN. Remember how the nth term will be denoted as AN. So like that, only sum of an AP of n term we can denote, we will denote as SN. Remember this. So SN we have denoted. So how to find this? So I will take that sum of first 4 terms. Okay. Sum of first 4 terms. We have to find the sum of the first 4 terms in this AP. So I have to write, what is the n value now? 4 terms they have given, so n value will be 4. So we have to find the 4 terms. So S4 we can write. So because here SN, yes, in here you have to write SN instead of SN. I will write on 4 because the n value is 4. 4 terms we have to find. So S4 is equal to what? It is nothing but we have to add this 1, 4, 7 and 10. The first 4 terms. So we will add that. So what will be the formula? We need one formula, yes, to write down. So I will take that formula as this one is A1 obviously, first term, second term, third term and the fourth term. So S4 is nothing but A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4, because S4 I have given. So like this we have to add. So A1 is how much? 1. A2 is 4. A3 is 7 and A4 is 10. Add together, so 1 plus 4 is 5, 5 plus 7 is 12, 12 plus 10 is 22. So our S4 value, the sum of the first 4 terms of the given AP, that is 1, 4, 7, 10 is nothing but 22. This is our answer. It is very easy, yes. But the same question if I will ask like this way. If I will ask the same AP, that is 1, 4, 7, 10, so on, how to find sum of first 20 terms. So here what have changed? I have not told you to find only the first 4 terms. I have asked here to find first 20 terms. So how you are going to find it? Means here obviously the n value we found, because 20 terms is nothing but n value, that is 20 terms we have, first 20 terms, so n value will be 20. So next, how we have to find the SN value, means sum of the n terms. So how we can find, means we want here SN, that is nothing but S20, because we know the n value is 20. So S20 we how we can find. So the same formula you will apply, SN is equals to the first term is 1, yes. So I will write, okay, I will write down as it is, A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4 plus A5, so on, you will add till how much? A20. But in the AP they have given how much? 1, 4, 7, 10, only 4 terms. Where is that 5th term? Where is the 6th term? Where is that 7th? Like this way till 20 terms they have not given. And you may tell that, sir, we can find, no? So 1 is the first term, 4 is the second term, 7, next will be 10. Obviously 3 difference everywhere we have. So next will be 30, next will be 16, next will be 19, next will be, like this way you can continue and you can tell we will write all the 20 terms one after the other. For example, like say 1 plus 4 plus 7 plus 10 plus 13 plus so on till 20 terms we will write, then we will add. You may tell like this way. If the same question was asked, if sum, find the sum, sum of first 100 terms. What have changed here? Third question I will take this one. Okay, this was the second one and here is was the first one. Okay, here it was the first. So first, second, third. The third question you can see, sum of first 100 terms I have given, means n values over here is 100. So S 100 we have to find, means sum of the 100 terms, first 100 terms we have to find. So whether you are going for this procedure, that is 1, 4, 7, 10, 13, 16, 19, 22. Like this way you will continue and you will do this procedure. I think if you do like this way in exam, the same question was asked, you need at least 1 hour for this to answer. You can't write that A1 plus A2, A3, so until 800, we can't write like this way and we can't find because it is a lengthy number, that is 100 numbers we have, so we can't do this. So what we have, that is one formula we have, that is SN formula. Using that SN formula, we can derive or we can find any one of the sum of the n terms, that is in AP. If it is in AP, we can find the sum of it very easily. It is similar to the AN formula but slightly changed. That I will teach you which formula it is today. For the derivation, I will take one more video for that. I will prepare one more video how to derive that, because derivation is not so important for the exam. But I will teach you what is that formula today, and derivation I will bring it in the next video. So what is that formula, we will see now. Sum of the first n terms of an AP is given by, so I have already told SN is the denoting of sum of the n terms, so SN is equals to, so here one thing is n by 2, that is the first thing we have to do, into, so I have written here bracket, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So this is the formula we have to remember as to find the sum of any first n terms of an AP. Sn is equals to what? N by 2 divided by 2a plus n minus 1 into d. And here everything you know already. Here Sn is nothing but the sum of the first n terms. So that is the Sn. N is the number of terms. How many terms we are finding the sum. For example, first two, in the example I have taken as the first 20 terms if it is you are finding. So here first 20 terms means here N is 20. Remember, means S 20 we have to find. So next, 2 is the constant, and here also 2 is a constant. A is nothing but the first term of the given AP. In the example 1, 4, 7, 10, so on, what you have here, that A is nothing but the first term. So in the next N value, N value means how many terms they have told you to find the sum. So N value already told, and D is nothing but the common difference, and this minus 1 remains as it is because it is a constant value. So this is the all about the SN formula. So what is the relation between the SN and AN now? I already told AN and SN both are what? Similar to see, to observe that, and some relation you also have. So similar formula I will continue now. So this is the formula you have to remember, that is SN formula. But what is the relation, once we will see relation between the SN and AN. Okay, now we have the relation between the SN and AN we have to find. So the thing is, remember SN I will write as it is, the same formula I will take now, and I will write that one. n by 2 also I will write as it is. But here 2a we have, yes? That 2a I will write down as a plus a, because a plus a is nothing but what? 2a. So I have written that 2a is what? A plus a. Remember this. Plus n minus 1 into d. So now if we will simplify it, n by 2. This a, you can see over here. This a, I will keep it outside. And this a and n minus 1 into d, this I will group 1. What is this group? We can do the group because here we have plus, so we can do the group. So I will write down this a as it is. See, the first a I have written as it is. But what is this whole group is? A plus n minus 1 into d. It is nothing but a plus n minus 1 into d. This is nothing but, you have already learned, that is nothing but an. So I can write down that Sn formula as n by 2 into a plus an also. Here a refers to the first term, an refers to what? The last term of a given AP. For example, if you know 1, 4, 7, 10, so on, I will take the last term as 19. So here if you want to find the sum and you know the first term and the last term and you know the n value also, directly you can find the Sn value, that is the sum of the first n terms, by using this formula also. If you know the first term and the last term and the n value, then. So this is the way, the second formula, same formula, we have one more. So this is also written as, remember this formula also written as n by 2 into a plus, instead of an, sometime we will write l also. Here l refers to an. Remember, this an is nothing but the l value they have taken. So an they have taken as l value, that is not nothing but the last term. Here last word came, so l is taken from that. Last term it is l, so we have taken as l. So don't get confused in these two formulas, that is Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus an, and Sn is equal to n by 2 a plus l. L and an both are the same. Here l refers to the last term. Here is the formula for you, that is the sum of the first n terms of an AP is given by, I have written, just you can check it out. That is next one, I have written the relation between the an, that is the nth term, and the Sn, that is the sum of the first n terms I have given. And the two formulas over here, you can see the first one over here, that is Sn, it is direct formula, and most of the cases you will use this. And the relation between the an and Sn are given as it is, where an and l are both are the same, that is the last term. So this is the thing you have to remember. And I also given where, what it is, the n means what, a means what, d means what, also an and l means what, that also have given. So you can refer that and you can note it down, very important. And based on this, now we will solve some of the problems, some examples we will solve to understanding the Sn formula. And one more formula you have, that I will discuss in the next class, because now if I'll give that formula, little bit you will get confused. So only these three formulas you have to remember, and most importantly the first formula, what you have over here, Sn is equals to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, that you have to learn. Based on that we will solve one example now. In the given question over here, you have to find the same question I have taken, what is already first what I have taken, that is example, find the sum of first 20 terms of given AP, that is 1, 4, 7, 10. So here what they have given, so AP is given 1, 4, 7, 10 and so on they have given. Not only this much, they have given one more thing, the sum of first 20 terms we have to find. So here 20 terms refers to what? Here somewhere you can find the A20. So that much till there you have to find the sum. So n value is nothing but, now directly we can write down as 20. So this is the thing they have given, sum of first 20 terms refers to, 20 terms refers to n value. So what they have given, the first term, that is A1, A2, A3, A4, so on. Whether they have given the last term, that is 20th term they have given, No, they have not mentioned. So 820 we have. So we can't go for that formula that is having the first term and the nth term. That is A and N. A plus N we had. Yes, one formula that we can't go because here they have not given 20th term. So which formula we have to go? That is the most importantly the main formula, that Sn is equals to N by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, where I have written already that formula we have to substitute and find this answer. To find that answer, so here again if you want I will write Sn is equals to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. We need the n value and we have that n value. Very good. So next one we need a value. A value is nothing but what? The first term. The first term is nothing but what? 1. So next we need n value. Again we've already written. So we need d value. D value is nothing but what? A2 minus A1. A2 is over here is 4 and A1 is here 1. So 4 minus 1 is nothing but 3. So we know that d value, that is 3. A value also we know and n value also we know. Substitute in this formula and find the answer. That is your n, that is Sn value, that sum of the first 20 terms. So n value is 20 divided by 2 into 2 into a value we need. A value already we know, that is how much? 1 plus n value is nothing but 20 minus 1. D value we found that 3. So here we can do the calculation. 2 1s are, 2 10s are. So 10 it is, 2 into 1 is 2 plus n minus 1, that is 20 minus 1 is nothing but 19. The d value how to multiply into 3. 10 into, now very importantly we can't multiply here 2, we can't add that 2 and 19 because we have to first, we have to do the into first, Bodmas rule we have to follow. So 2 plus 19 threes are how much? 19 threes are how much? 57. Next, what is the next case? 10 how to write as it is. 2 plus 57 is nothing but 59. So I will write down here, okay? So S20 is equals to 10 into 59. What is 10 into 59? Most and easiest thing. Whenever the multiplying with the 10, when it will come, the same number we have to write as it is 5. 9. Next one 0 we have, that is 590. So sum of first 20 terms of the given AP, that is 1, 4, 7, 10, so on. That is nothing but 590. But it is very easy to find. So you can write down directly the sum of first 20 terms of given AP. That is, we can write down that AP. That is 1, 4, 7, so on, is, that is, answer is 590. That is our final answer. It is not difficult, it is easy. You can also find sum of first 100 also. What we have to do when we are finding the sum of 100 first term? That nothing we have to do, the same method we have to follow. But here, n value is how much? N value will become 100. If you want to find S26, again the n value is changed, that is 26. Like this way we have to change the n value and AP, in that we have to find the first term and the common difference, that is d. If you found this much, we can solve any one of the problem. So remember this formula and do the calculation. Coming to the last, that is the arithmetic progression, that question for your work at home. Here are the two questions. That is the first one, question A. Find the sum of first 100 terms of the AP 1, 4, 7, 10. And second question B. Question B is over here. If the first term of an AP is 10 and the 44th term is 54, find the sum of first 44 terms of the given AP. Both are looks similar, but the first one you have to solve by one formula and second one you have to solve by one more formula. So read the question correctly, then you can answer it very easily. So this much is for today's class. That is very important topic. It was sum of the first n terms. So please support my channel, that is Perfect Solution for Math, that is PSM. Please like, subscribe and share. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video. Till then, take care.